Multiply and divide the rational expressions. Problem number 8. X cubed plus 8 over x squared minus 3x divided by x squared minus 4 over x minus 3. Again, we have to factor each individual part. So starting up here, x cubed plus 8. That looks like the sum of two cubes. So we need a formula for that, and the formula would be a plus b and then a squared minus ab plus b squared. In this case, our a is equal to x and our b is equal to 2, because 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. So just following the formula and plugging in our a and b value, we get x plus 2 and then x squared minus x times 2, which is 2x, and then plus 2 squared, which is 4. So done factoring this first part. Now moving on to the bottom, x squared minus 3x. In this case, both of them have a common factor, a greatest common factor of x. Pulling out an x, we are left with x minus 3. Now on the right side, this is the difference of two perfect squares. And we can write our empty sets of parentheses, square root the first term, so x and x, and square root the second term, which is 2, 2, and then we need a plus and a minus. Now, this one, there's nothing we can do, so we just bring it down. And now, because we're dealing with a division problem, we're going to apply the rule of keeping the first fraction as is. So x plus 2 and then x squared minus 2x plus 4 all over x minus 3. And then we're changing the sign to multiplication, and we are going to flip the second fraction. So now the x minus 3 is on top, and x plus 2, x minus 2 is in the bottom. We are ready to cancel out terms now. So we have x plus 2 on top, x plus 2 on top, x minus 3, x minus 3, and we rewrite what's left, so we have x squared minus 2x plus 4, and we got x and x minus 2. You might assume that this is factorable because this is a trinomial with a coefficient of 1, but remember the factors of this last number, the factors of 4, in this case, because the signs are different, so you would get the two factors of 4 to give you 2, but there are no factors of 4 that would add to give you 2. Therefore, this would be your answer unless you decide to distribute this x into the bottom one to just get rid of the parentheses, and then you would get x squared minus 2x plus 4 and x squared minus 2x. So now this is your final answer for this problem.